They should be really proud of themselves. But what they have trouble with is settling down with a certain person or finding love in meaningful places. And this is what happened. Todd and Corinna, I'm friends with both of them, so I've kind of been trying to be the matchmaker and pin them together for a really long time. And it helps with my videos because I love walking in on them when they're doing their thing.
It helps with my videos when I ruin their lives.
So this just happened, and we went to Las Vegas recently. And it was a lot of fun. But the day before we went to Vegas, Todd and Corinna finally tied the knot, as you would say, and Corinna slept with
her. That's not tying the knot. We finally really
connected.
Yeah.
Your knots touched. So they ended up hooking up. They did the whole thing. I don't want to get into detail. And then we get to Vegas, and literally 12 hours later, it's like it's nighttime. It's like, I don't know, 2 a.m. What is it, 3 a.m.? I hear someone came to my door. I think Liza came to my room because I was in another room. They were in a room completely by themselves with everybody in the room. And Liza's like, Corinna's crying. Todd and Corinna are in a fight. And it's because Todd had another girl over in his bed.
To win glory.
Hooking up, but Corinna felt some type of way about Todd, and Todd's just Todd, so he felt good about himself, so he's like, I'm gonna have a night to myself. And Corinna, explain this part of the situation. How did you run into Todd?
Well, I was sharing a I was sharing a room with the girl that he ended up hooking up with.
Oh.
So when I woke up,
she had every right to be there too.
What'd you say?
Whatever happens in Vegas stays in Vegas, is that
yeah.
right?
Except if there's two girls and they're trying to battle over you in the same room.
And chlamydia, that comes back from Vegas.
That's the thing for Joe. Okay, so Corinna comes to Liza and she groups all the girls together. She's crying. She's like, I can't believe Todd would do this. And all the girls are like, are you fucking stupid?
I'm settling down soon.
And then I asked Liza, I'm like, Liza, this is amazing. Like, they don't, like, the way I see Todd and Corinna is, it's not like a real, like, I've always told them this. I'm like, you two are two good-looking people, and you guys are young. Like, just enjoy yourselves, hook up with each other, and then you'll find true love. And, like, that's the way I view the relationship, is just, like, two bodies rubbing against each other. And this is what I explained to Liza. I'm like, Liza, I need to go out there, and I need to film this. Because I heard Corinna was crying, so I'm like, I need to get in on this action. And Liza was like, you are crazy. She was so disappointed in me. And then I FaceTimed Jason at 4 a.m. It's 4 a.m. when this is all going down.
I was irate. He called me at 4 a.m. And then
I told him what was going on.
And I was like, oh, thank God you called me. This is the best.
And it was just so tough for me not to be able to film. And during the whole time, we wake up the next morning, and they're good now, as you can see, because they bounce back like this. They're like still like children. So Todd can go to a strip club and hook up with every stripper there, and Corinna will be like, it's okay. It's one night. So during this whole thing, I'm friends with both Todd and Corinna. So Todd's coming up to me on the side, and he's like, dude, why is Corinna so mad? You're never dating. I'm like, oh yeah, fuck her, dude, that's fucked up. And then Corinna would come up to me and she'd be like, I thought we had something, what's going on? Yeah, fuck Todd, you know Todd. And I was just feeding the energy for both the sides, and it was great. And they wouldn't let me post any of the drama because I did end up filming, because they were upset with each other. And then they wait like 2 days and they come back and they're, look at this. They look like they're in love. God, explain your side of the situation.
My side.
She was hot.
We made it clear. I was drunk, I was gambling. We made it clear that we were together.
And it was, yeah, okay, on Todd's side completely, they weren't dating, right? So, well, if you guys were to say, was Todd okay? Was he able to hook up with other girls?
Okay, can I say my thing? Like, yes, I feel for Todd, I get it. We weren't dating, but I was in his bed the night before, so.
So an Uber to the airport.
To be fair, but like, I feel like the girl that was in his bed the night before, you can come up on stage and have the same argument. It just doesn't count. I feel like if you're not dating and you're Todd and you're Corinna, I think you guys should be able to.
Yeah, it's Todd. Look at him. He's so lovable. I mean, how could you be mad at him?
Oh, no, like, to be truthful, I felt terrible the next day. I had so much anxiety. I felt awful. I was a dick.
It was a mess.
And I tried to talk to her, and she blocked my number, my Instagram, my Snapchat, my Twitter.
Dude, do that. So, hold on. Don't get on Corinna's side, guys. You have to realize that they weren't dating. And this is what they do. When Todd does something wrong, or when Corinna does something wrong, they block each other. And it gets to the point where Todd is emailing Corinna, and he's like, oh, why don't you talk to me? And it's just getting passed down through messages, then she'll block the email, then he'll shoot me an email, and it just keeps going. It's a beautiful relationship, but they're doing a lot better.
But Todd can't. Todd's come home to the house and been like, oh, Corinna was all over this other guy tonight. He's been upset too, Corinna.
Yeah.
Corinna. Yes. Yeah, he's been upset. He's like, I don't know what's going on with Corinna tonight. She was just all over this other guy. And ho, ho, ho. And hold on, let me look in the mirror real quick. Okay, I look fantastic. Back to Corinna.
No, but overall, I think that, are you guys exclusive now? Or are you guys a thing? What's going on?
Well, we had to get ready for Chicago, so we're gonna be
happy. Yeah.
Chicago. You can say Chicago, and the section is gonna start fucking cheering.
Where are you guys from?
Chicago.
Oh. I wanna bring. Oh shit. Fuck. Hold on. There are plenty of hookup sites out there. That is not what they are. Right now, my listeners can get a free Mamba V Harmony when they sign up for a 3-month subscription. Enter my code VIEWS at checkout. Thank you, Todd and Corinna, for helping us with the Harmony.